Hyperkalemia is defined as serum potassium more than 5.5 millimoles per liter. Causes of hyperkalemia include renal failure, acidosis such as DKA and lactic acidosis, medications such as angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors, tissue breakdown like in rhabdomyolysis and tumor lysis syndrome. Symptoms include muscle weakness, paresthesia, ECG changes, and cardiac arrhythmias. Shifting potassium levels, especially in cases of hyperkalemia, must be done carefully to avoid cardiac and neuromuscular complications. The first step is to stabilize the cardiac membrane, usually indicated when there are ECG changes. 10 mL of 10% calcium gluconate IV over 5 to 10 minutes is administered. It is repeated if ECG changes persist and avoided in digoxin toxicity. The second step is to shift potassium intracellularly with insulin and dextrose. 10 units of regular insulin is administered, followed by 50 mL of 50% dextrose. Glucose should be monitored closely and infusion adjusted as needed. Nebulization with beta-agonists such as salbutamol. 10 to 20 mg is nebulized over 10 minutes. It can lower potassium by 0.5 to 1.0 millimoles per liter. Sodium bicarbonate is administered if metabolic acidosis is present. 50 mL equivalent IV over 5 minutes is given. It is less effective in non-acidotic patients. The third step is the removal of potassium from the body. Loop diuretics is given if volume status allows. 20 to 40 mg IV furosemide is administered. It enhances renal potassium excretion. Sodium polystyrene sulfonate, also known as kayexalate, or paterosmer, is also used. 15 to 30 grams of kayexalate orally or rectally is given. It works over hours and not used for emergencies. Dialysis is indicated for severe cases, chronic kidney disease, or refractory hyperkalemia. Key takeaways from this video is that hyperkalemia requires a stepwise approach. Stabilize cardiac membrane using calcium gluconate. Shift potassium intracellularly with insulin, dextrose, beta-agonists, and bicarbonate. Removal of potassium with diuretics, kayexalate, and dialysis. Monitor ECG and potassium levels frequently. Treat underlying cause to prevent recurrence. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.